What are you waiting for? 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 As we go towards the light.
Yeah. But
and you thought you weren't going to have enough stuff to play. Wow. What an amazing set, guys. Thank you so much for coming in the studio. Thank Did you enjoy that?
Yeah, thanks of course. For the drinks. We had a lot of fun, yeah. Thank you so much for having us.
Hey, look, anytime. So what did we hear in the mix? Were there any of the album tracks, any of your own productions? I heard some special booties in there.
We try to play, you know, a lot of bootlegs as original as possible. We played the Save the World remix, obviously, is being played right now. Then there was another one there that's off of our album. But we tried to kind of keep it to ourselves for now because we're still tweaking things. We don't want to, when we finally show it to people, you know, people obviously hear it in the clubs when we play it, but we want it to be perfect, so yeah.
Exactly. Now, I mean, it must feel really exciting. I mean, how old are you, Antoine?
How old am I?
Yeah.
21.
Max?
25.
I mean, you're achieving some pretty incredible things, you know, at that age. Definitely. You know, I mean, does it feel quite amazing to be part of this new generation of producers and DJs that
amazing
are kind of coming
and
through
very
the
ranks? Unreal.
Unreal. Yeah. Unreal. Like, yeah.
You wake up every day and wonder, oh shit, I forgot.
Yeah, seriously. We wake up in the morning, we make music, we travel around the world, we play music to the people, and just people love it. You know, it's the most amazing thing. You know, the chances of obviously achieving something like that are very slim, so we're very fortunate and very happy.
I mean, sorry to interrupt you, but you hear these strings, how nice they are?
They're, oh,
they're beautiful. They're beautiful.
It's a fun story how we made them, but we're not gonna.
Yeah, I was actually in the bathroom when he was playing them, and I was like, "Come out!" I run out of the
what
bathroom.
What did you do in the bathroom?
Doesn't matter what I was doing in the bathroom, but I run out. I'm like, "Shit, that's what it is." He's like, "What is?" I'm like, "Well, you were playing right there." Yeah, and we kept them, so they were good.
Awesome. When inspiration strikes.
Yeah, yeah. Definitely.
Okay, now let's talk a little bit about the gigs. I mean, Sensation White, that's coming up.
Oh my God, that's crazy. We got it this week in Amsterdam, the big one, the first one this year for the whole new concept, Inner Space, and wow, that's incredible. Can't believe it still.
Yeah. And then also filling in, as we said, for the Swedes, yeah, and that, at the Masquerade Motel. I mean, that. I mean, what was it like the first time that you actually played Pasha?
Oh shit, I remember.
I was nervous as shit.
Yeah,
it was like
too.
Ridiculous.
I've never been that nervous in my entire life, I think.
Yeah.
Maybe my first sex debut, but I don't know. It's something of those two that.
Yeah, it was definitely probably. I was more nervous before Pasha actually than before the first Sensation we did in Prague. That was like unreal because, you
not
know,
different.
You need to. It was just when you're in the booth. I remember coming to Ibiza before and, you know, watching DJs play, and now I'm like, okay, so now I'm in the booth doing this.
Yeah.
So my hands are shaking. I'm like, I need a drink, quick.
Stomach.
Yeah.
Sweating.
But then you can't. Yeah, you try to drink to relax, but you can't drink too much because you're gonna fuck it up.
Exactly.
You know
you're
what
gonna
I mean?
Fall off the
so
cliff.
So it's gotta be like a perfect balance. Yeah.
Yeah.
Nice. I mean, let's actually talk a little bit about your performance. I mean, who kind of inspires you as DJs? You know, who have you seen kind of playing before and just, you know, say when you were growing up or whatever, and you were just like, okay, they're pretty special.
Well, obviously Steve, my brother.
For me, Steve, number one DJ, he's so fucking good. It's insane. Like, we were just on tour, the bus tour, so we kind of like know exactly what he does now, like which tracks, edits, whatever, and it's just incredible. I haven't seen a single club where he didn't get the crowd completely, you know, smashed.
No, but it's not just about doing a 2 or 3 hour set killing it. What I think separates the DJs, it's he can play for 9 to 10 hours. And
yeah.
I remember when I used to be able to do 6 hours, now it's just, it's hard.
It's tough, it's
wow.
tough.
I mean, as a DJ myself, I remember sort of going to hear someone like DJ Sneak or Danny Tenaglia, and I'm like, how are you pulling out these tracks after 6, 7 hours? Why haven't you played this already?
Or how can you carry that many vinyls?
Yeah.
These days, it's cheating. Before, the hardest work was to actually get the vinyls to the club.
Okay, it's very interesting that you said that, because obviously you guys are playing off USB, yeah?
Yeah. Yeah. And SDs.
And some
SDs. Till my SD driver died.
And using Rekordbox, yeah?
Definitely.
Now, how has that changed the way that you play? I mean, did you transfer straight away over to Rekordbox, or did you?
I did it straight away. For me, it was really, everybody's like, I don't know how to organize it. And I always organized my CDs in a special way. I had like 6 tracks on every CD in every playlist through iTunes. I just played like Bridge, and you sync it, and it was done.
So now, oh, sorry, Max.
No. I was gonna say that it's just getting ridiculously too easy. Like, I don't even know what we're getting paid for anymore.
Clubs, you know? Yeah, you come into the club, they're like,
Can't please.
Yeah, it's like,
where's your CD? It's in my pocket.
No, but it's actually, it's good because now that this is becoming easier and easier, it becomes more difficult on people. You really need to produce music. If you don't know how to produce, there's really no, pretty much impossible to do anything in the industry, I would say.
Okay, I mean, and when you're actually playing, I mean, I noticed there was a lot of echoes going along, a lot of filters.
Echo, filtering, looping.
They're called time fillers, basically, when you're playing.
Yeah. Excellent, wonderful. So you've got Pasha tonight.
Yeah.
Yes.
You've got the new album coming out this summer.
Yeah.
Or
yeah.
thereabouts.
That's the yeah. That's going to be exciting.
We're working on it for 1 year now.
Yeah.
Crazy.
And a live, any live show, any kind of performing the tracks live, anything like that?
Well, we're gonna probably play everything tonight at Pasha, you know, most of the stuff that we have off the album, the stuff that's mixed
but I'm telling
properly.
One.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Yeah. Thanks so much, guys, for coming into the studio. What
Thank
a great
you.
Mix.
Thank you.
What a pleasure.
Thank you.
Indeed.
Okay. So this is Dante signing out on the Pioneer DJ Sound Show. Thank you so much, Antoine and Max Vangeli, for that incredible mix. Really heated things up in here. Okay, this is Dante. Thank you very much. Goodbye.